In this video, I'm gonna show you three ways how you can utilize the Google Tag Manager object. All and more coming up. Hey there, measurers, Julian here, back with another video for you. Now, today we want to talk about the Google Tag Manager object. If you are a bit more advanced in Google Tag Manager implementations, you have probably utilized the data layer. This is our central repository for structured data that we want to utilize with our tags and our triggers and our variables. And so we can make it available to Google Tag Manager through the data layer. But there's actually a step in between, which is not often talked about, and this is the internal data model of Google Tag Manager. So once we push data into the data layer, it actually gets stored inside of the internal data model and then get pulled out by your data layer variables or your triggers or your tags. And this is really the internal representation of your structured data inside of Google Tag Manager. We can actually utilize this internal data model for our tag deployments, but we would need to have a way to access it. And this is what we do with the Google Tag Manager object. Now, how can this actually be useful, this internal data model? Today, I want to show you my three ways on how I utilize this often for my tag deployment, speed up my workflow, and make other cool stuff happen. Now, without further ado, we got lots to cover, so let's dive in.
Welcome back to our demo shop. Now, let's take a look, first of all, at our Google Tag Manager object. We can access it by going into our developer tools in Google Chrome, for example, that would be here, and then navigating onto the console, we will have access to the JavaScript runtime environment where we can put in our commands. And we simply type Google underscore tag underscore manager. And this is the object that we are talking about. Now, in order to access it, you will need to have your GTM ID ready, because it might be that there are different objects for different containers. And we can access our container by these square brackets, double quotes, and our GTM container ID. We press enter, and here we can see all the different methods that we have available. Take a look at the data layer. This is the internal data model that you can access through this JavaScript object. All we need to do is write a dot and then data layer. And from here, I'll show you my first tip. So through the get method, we can actually get any kind of value from the data layer without needing to create a data layer variable. So for example, on this page, it's a product page. We have our data layer here, and we can see we have already some information inside of the data layer. Now, if we would like to build a tag inside of Google Tag Manager, and I have something prepared here already, where we want to send over an event to Facebook. And in that Facebook event, we want to send a track call to view content. And I would like to have the actual product name in here. Now, obviously, I could look at my data layer and then create a variable within Google Tag Manager, a data layer variable, and then go back and input this with the two curly brackets. But what if I only wanted to use this variable once and only for this tag? Since we're here already in the context of JavaScript, as we're here in a custom HTML tag, I could just use our Google Tag Manager object to access this value. How would I do that? Well, just like a data layer variable, you would need to put in your key for the data layer into the variable. And so I'm gonna just write .get here and then enter the variable key. In our case, that would be e-commerce.detail. And since this is an array here that I can see here in the square brackets, I will write 0 and then name. And I can press enter and I can see if this was resolved. Unfortunately, I made a mistake here, just so I forgot the products actually. So let's go back here and put this after the detail. We have our products and 0 and name. And we can see here we get the name. So this would actually be the code that runs in the background if you would create a data layer variable. And so we could just use this code directly in the environment of JavaScript right here and resolve it this way. Let's try this out. Let's save this and refresh. Go back to our page, our tag fires, and we have our view content with our product name, Happy Ninja. So this was correctly resolved and would work also for the next product if you go over here. So really a fast way to use the Google Tag Manager object to not have to build a data layer variable, especially if you just use it once. Now let's move on to the second tip. What if you wanted to capture certain attributes from a click? So if I click here on the Add to Cart button, I get a GTM link click. I already installed a click trigger, but now I would like to pick up a certain element that lives in the background. Let's take a look. If I go to inspect element here, we can see that this link, this ahref, has a data product ID, which I would like to pull out as I don't have it in my data layer yet. Now, how could I accomplish this? I wouldn't be able to use something like a DOM element variable, as this would only be evaluated once the page loads. But every time a user clicks on an Add to Cart button, I would like to re-evaluate this based on what the user has clicked on. Luckily, the Google Tag Manager object lets us access the data model within Google Tag Manager, and that would be possible again through the dataLayer.get variable, but this time we want to get a built-in variable, which would be gtm.element. And here we can always see what link was last clicked on. So if I click here again on Add to Cart and I repeat this command, and by the way, I just press the up arrow to get the last command back, press enter again, we now see that we always have the last value that is currently written into the data layer to our disposal here within JavaScript. So this is great because every time somebody clicks, I could write a little bit of a command to pull out the actual data product ID. How would I do this? Well, we can just go over to Google Tag Manager and build a custom JavaScript variable. So go over to new and build a custom JavaScript variable. This custom JavaScript variable will be for our product ID. And custom JavaScript variable, we will need an anonymous function that returns something. Now in between, we want to do an extraction of the data. So we'll pull our GTM element here, and then we want to do an operation on it, which is pull out the data product ID. How would you do that? Well, we can utilize a command called dot get attribute, and then in parentheses, our selector, in this case, data minus product underscore ID. And we can test it out all beforehand, and we get 50 back. This is what we wanted. So let's go ahead and copy this. We actually don't need to put it up here, but we can just simply return it right away, just like that. Let's save this and try it out. And every time I click on an Add to Cart button here, we should see in our variables the product ID being filled differently with each GTM click. So now we could utilize this in our tag. We already have a tag prepared. This is the Add to Cart tag where I'm sending off a Facebook event, and I would like to input our product ID. This time we have it saved in a variable right here and have it available. By the way, even going back to the tip number one, we could write the whole line in here without actually needing to build a variable itself within the custom JavaScript variable. Even cleaner and even less assets inside of your Google Tag Manager account. But if you would like to reuse this variable in other tags, then you might want to put this into a variable and abstract it this way. Let's save this, refresh, see what happens. And if Facebook receives the data, we'll add to cart, and we have a new event here that is a click event, and the product ID is 53. So really great use of the Google Tag Manager object as well. Last but not least, I often use this when I would like to utilize the Matches CSS Selector option. So if I would like to build a trigger to trigger on the top here of the menu itself, I could obviously build different triggers for clothing, hoodies, t-shirts, and so on. But to keep it as clean as possible, you might want to utilize the Matches CSS Selector. What does that mean? Well, if we would like to fire this tag upon our menu click, we would need to build a trigger, a new click trigger for our menu clicks, and that would be the all elements trigger. And then we only want to fire this when a certain element, and in our case that would be the click element, matches the CSS selector. Now, what do we fill into this matches CSS selector? And why we use the click element? Well, let's check out our page again. I need to save this, so I'm just gonna put in here one just for now and refresh our preview in debug mode so we can see the GTM element. Now, matches CSS selector only works on HTML elements. So if you have a GTM click here and we go to variables, we see that the click element just shows object HTML div element. Doesn't really matter where I click, I get a new GTM click and our click element gets filled with the actual object of the HTML value. What is in the background of that? Let's check it out inside of our Google Tag Manager object. Open up the developer tools again, go back to our command, and this time I want to get the GTM element. Here we go. We have just clicked here on the search, and therefore this is the element that would be evaluated in terms of our trigger. We also have this available if you click, for example, on this image here, go back again. Each time the value gets pulled and we have the GTM element available to us to be evaluated in our trigger. Now, the crucial part that we want to actually look at is the menu up here. So I'm gonna click on these and gonna press the up arrow, enter, and here we get the last element, which was the t-shirt element. If I right click on this, it will actually let me reveal this element in the elements panel. And that will give me my elements panel up here where I can see the HTML. Now, a little trick in the DevTools is to press the escape key, which will underneath open up the console as well. So we'll be able to look at and see how our HTML will behave based on our input here. Now, when we look back onto the HTML, we can see that all of these elements right here are within an UL element with the ID menu main. So this is what I would like to use as a CSS selector to actually mark and try to capture all of these different elements that are beneath this UL. For this, I would need to have the right CSS selector that matches up to the elements beneath it. So let's take a look at how we can do this. If we have the right GTM element here already, we can simply use the matches command, and then with our quotation marks, we can enter our CSS selector and see if it matches up. So here we have an ahref. So if you put just a in, you can see the matches CSS selector would turn true in this instant. Now, as I could choose any element here, let's choose this one, I get a new GTM element. And if I click here and press A, it would also turn true. So that's obviously not right. We don't want it to turn true only if it's up here in the navigation itself. So again, we will utilize our CSS skills to make up a CSS selector that only matches up if the clicked element is actually a descendant of the UL with the ID menu main. Let's see if this works. No, it doesn't for the image that we have just clicked, but let's look for the hoodie. And we can see here it turns true. What about the albums? Here it turns true again. And let's do a negative test. Let's click here. And it turns false. So we have now a CSS selector that we could use inside of our trigger. With that in mind, we can utilize this. Go over to Google Tag Manager, go back into our clicks here, and say we only want to fire this if the matches CSS selector equals this term. Let's save this, refresh, go back to our page, reload this. And now if I click on any element up here, we have our GTM click and our tag doesn't fire. Let's go back here. Oh, we haven't actually connected it to the tag itself. So let's do that really quickly itself. Menu clicks, refresh this. Let's go back here. And now click on our menu and we see the GA event menu click has fired. If you click on any other element, it doesn't fire. And now we have tagged with the help of the CSS selector, all of these menu points up here and the tag fires. So really another great way to use the Google Tag Manager object to test your CSS selectors beforehand and make sure they are working.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can utilize the Google Tag Manager object. Do you have any other use cases that you use the Google Tag Manager object for? Oftentimes, I would love to hear from you in the comments down below. And if you like this video, why not give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Happy measuring.